We were working on a horse, and the horse hit me right in the knee.
Now I'm on a pretty strict regimen of rest. This is the worst time of year that I could get hurt. It's the busiest time on the farm.
We're all just gonna have to pick up the pieces and figure out how to make this work.
The sheep are gonna give birth soon.
Come on, let's go look at the lamb.
Guess what I see? A baby. Yay! Come on, kiddo. We got chores to do. We can't dilly-dally. You ready to feed emus?
Yeah.
My injury has definitely been a real curveball. This has forced me to accept my boundaries.
You're gonna pour it in, sweet pea? You making your chores take longer because you're having fun?
At the same time, it's been a blessing in a way because it has allowed Beth to get more involved. And she has a different touch than I do. The animals, they're getting tamer because she just takes a couple extra minutes. Definitely the emus, but also the sheep and
the newborn lamb.
Under the chin, just under the chin.
You know, that's just Beth going out there every day and spending that time. It's been almost a year since we started transforming the, hey, buddy. It's almost been exactly a year since we started building this farm, but we have a million projects that we have to finish. We have to split the beehives. We have to fix the water issue within the sheep hut again, and we have to plant the garden.
It's not a salad. That's a weed. The weeds are in the ground here. The garden will have the salads.
Very soon, Beth's parents are going to come for planting day.
We always look forward to Art and Judy coming.
We know them for,
gosh, what is it, 50 years probably, isn't it?
Yeah.
With good friends like this, you can be apart for a couple of years. You come together and you start talking like you saw them yesterday.
Our whole story in this entire farm goes back to my parents meeting Beth and Ben's parents. They brought these two families together, so now we're gonna have one big party. Oh, buddy, you're getting so big. You know, one day all of this is gonna be your and Abigail's. Yeah, that's Mommy and Abigail.
Typical morning chores, check on all the animals, make sure everybody's good from overnight. I really appreciate the help. I mean, both the kids are growing so much, and Abigail's really moving from that kind of toddler stage to that young girl where she is just interested in what's going on around her and engaging in a new way.
Can you get this down?
I sure can. There you are.
20 pounds of grain go to those cows in the morning. Her little scoops started out so small, and now she takes these ginormous scoops.
Oh, my goodness.
I got a little more minimal.
Let's count them. 1, 2, 3.
Lefty, loosey, righty, tighty.
Lefty, loosey, righty, tighty. It's great bonding time for the two of us, but there is one chore that she can't help with just yet. Here we come, bees.
The bees have made it through winter, and the colony is very robust. There's just no extra space for these bees to go, and so it's time to split them.
The hive is like a lot of people in the apartment complex, and some folks were thinking about packing up.
The first sign of this is the formation of queen cups, which means that the colony is preparing to make a new queen to replace the old queen, who is going to take the vast majority of that colony and fly away to a new address. So we're trying to keep all of our bees here on the farm, and we're giving them a new apartment building right next to their old one to live in.
This is the hive that we're gonna split. This is where we're gonna split the new hive to.
The existing colony lives in these two stackable boxes. Inside these boxes are 8 rectangular frames that the bees use for laying eggs and producing honey. To split this colony, you just switch some of the frames from the old box into the new box while making sure that the queen cups with those eggs are going into the new hive.
Those are queen cups. And so inside one of these is going to be my future queen, and that is going to create a separate colony. All right, guys, looking so beautiful. I love it. I'm gonna add these new frames in, but this one's super cool. Look at that. It's like a piece of art. All right.
It'll take a few weeks for the relocated bees to start building out their new hive. I have to wait and be patient, walk away, and let nature and the bees do their job.
After weeks of rest, my injury hasn't fully recovered yet, but my knee has healed enough that I could be more active on the farm. Fixing the sheep hut is the first thing on my agenda.
We concreted the inside of this, right? But what it did is it pushed our problem out here, right?
Yeah.
The sheep hut itself is structurally sound. The issue that we have is we built it literally in a puddle in the middle of the field. The entire 8 acres around it drains right to that spot.
We built this in a low point.
We? I didn't pick the spot. You picked the spot.
You didn't check the spot. So
it's my fault.
No, I picked the spot. You built it in a low point. And I picked the spot.
Okay. This whole little hump right here is what's just kicking our rear end. I think it makes sense for us to cut this grade down about a foot. And that way, then every time it rains, everything's just gonna kind of flow that direction. There's a slight hill outside of the sheep hut. By removing the hill, we're able to allow that water to flow unobstructed away from the sheep hut. Let's just spend the time and make it right.
Handle. Okay, good job. Water for Jane and Romeo. Here we go. Watch your head, Romeo.
Romeo is the newest member of the flock. His mother, Jean, gave birth this spring. When a sheep gives birth, you keep the lamb and the mother isolated from the flock for a while.
You have to have a bond that has to come between the lamb and you. If not, then many times the lamb doesn't know what you is his mother, and yeah, dies.
Oh my goodness, you're so big, buddy. So big, so quick, I'm gonna miss our snuggles.
I didn't want to name him because I didn't know what our status was going to be with keeping him. Our original plan was to grow our flock with more female sheep, but he just Romeo'd his way into my heart, so we are going to be keeping Romeo in our pasture.
I cannot wait to see what he's going to do when you give him all of this open green space to suddenly explore.
Well, let's ask my dad. He's going to be here and see what he thinks. We have to get my dad to sign off on the changes to the grading in front of the sheep hut. Hey.
Good morning, sir.
Good news. Ben had an epiphany. Why don't you tell him?
This whole sheep hut thing is like... So we're gonna take out the section of fencing from the water tower to that gate and just grade it all out so it grades out, it flows out to the field.
We only have to go about 25, 30 feet from the fence before it's 18
yes,
inches
but it's
lower.
Going downhill. It looks good if you do it. Let's see what happens.
Deal. Thank you,
sir.
Thank
appreciate
you.
It.
Thank you, sir.
Take care. We'll see ya.
See ya. Well, that went well.
Yeah. You did agree.
All right, Charles, let's get to work. We're burning daylight.
Fast. Burning daylight fast. Oh, there's just one minor issue.
What?
We're gonna have to do something with the animals when we pull down the fence.
We do, but we're gonna need somebody else here other than just you because I don't think you're gonna run as fast as the sheep or the cows. Let me get my guys. Come on, no more nap time. We're gonna go for a field trip. Not that way. Hup! Yeah, there we go. Perfect.
Okay, let's shut those gates before the sheep come back.
Up. Are we good right here?
We're good.
That worked out great. All right, fence. There, perfect.
I can't wait to see what we've got going on in our hive after our split. I'm gonna check the back hive first since this is the new one. So on this first hive, our split, I'm not expecting to see a whole lot because the timing is just super tight. It's really impossible for a new queen to have fully emerged. Man, you guys are just really buzzing, aren't you? Look at that. They are creating the foundation.
That is beautiful. It's like a teardrop.
And I have a growing sense of pride as I work through this and figure it out. The more I'm successful with them, the more I'm feeling a sense of accomplishment.
You gotta give it to her.
Yes.
She started out being somewhat afraid of those bees.
Anybody home? Oh, there's a bee. No, that was a fly.
Now she's out there like a bee expert.
Beautiful activity. I love it.
Andy, this is gonna be our highest point.
Correct.
So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna slope from here out as far as we need to.
As far as we need to go.
To our lowest point.
Yep.
In order to make sure that we've got good pitch and good swell. So, other side.
Yep.
So this, the bottom of this stick, is now
2 inches below the top of concrete.
Yeah. We need to create a downward slope from there to here. This spot will be our new low point. It's already lower than the sheep hut. The issue is we have a hill in between the two points. Once the hill is removed, the water will be able to flow unrestricted. Now you have the machines and have some fun and move some dirt. This is my favorite part.
I'm curious about what's going on inside that other hive. See what we've got or don't have. So this is a brand new frame that they have loaded full of honey. They have built this entire thing. My guess is that these are all gonna be very full of honey. The frames, they're just loaded full of honey. Unbelievable. And I'm very excited because it's a sign of a very happy, healthy colony. That's so beautiful.
So what I've got with me now is a super, which is this box that's built out with a bunch of frames. The bees are gonna have all kinds of new space to get to work on, and they're gonna be really happy because it's like I just added another story onto their apartment building.
A super is a box that lets you safely collect honey without disturbing eggs and larvae. It's separated from the eggs and larvae by a mesh called a queen excluder. The openings in it are too small for the queen to pass through, but large enough for the worker bees to move on up and make honey.
Okay, everyone. Come on, guys.
I wanted bees because I wanted honey. And so having these bees and getting to the point where I may have a honey harvest yet as we move into the summer, it's just so exciting and it makes me feel really good to have had just this little success.
All right, let's close this up and get back inside. All right, I think we got it. Love it.
Finishing touches on the permanent fix for the sheep hut. Finito! Best solution ever!
Looks good.
I win. I am so excited.
This solves all our issues.
Now the water's not gonna dam up in front of the sheep hut and it's gonna flow out into the pasture.
Now that we're done, it's time to bring the animals back.
Time to get the animals, buddy. Let's bring them home.
Come on, everybody.
There you go.
You know the way home.
Come on.
Hey, we're pretty good at wrangling.
Don't you want to go see your buddies?
Going back to the pasture.
There you go.
All right, guys. Nat a girl.
I can't wait to put Romeo out in the pasture. I'm just super excited to see the enthusiasm that he's gonna have when he realizes all of this space is available to him.
Hi, guys. Wanna go for a road trip?
Road trip!
All right.
One last snuggle, Romeo. Oh, buddy, I'm gonna miss your snuggles. He's a big boy now. You're a big boy.
Aww. Okay.
So sad. It's like he's leaving the nest.
Okay, hang on. Mom's coming.
Come on, lady. We're gonna go. All your friends are this way. Come on. Mama, where are we? We've landed in Oz.
I'm really gonna miss my snuggles with Romeo, but I know this is what's best for him. And I get to wander out and yell, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? And hopefully he comes, but probably not. I don't think they're trainable like that.
And the thing is gone. I believe it.
There's the little one mixing with everybody else.
Who are you? Who are you? Those should we get planting?
We're gonna start with this bed right here, one of the big ones, and we'll do the herb one then next.
How you doing, Jan?
I'm doing fine.
I love having my parents here. The relationship between Charles's parents and my parents goes back decades, before Ben and I and Charles were even born.
Oh, Silas is just gone, isn't he?
This year, starting our family farm has brought us really close in a special way. We have worked our tails off to make something that's really special and memorable and that our parents will be proud of, and it's all coming together in a culmination today with the garden.
You're doing a good job, lady.
He sure is.
Yeah.
Abigail, Opa's foot right here.
No. Then you go like this.
Ah!
Ha-ha! Isn't that fun?
Beth's been looking forward to planting since we broke ground on the garden, but I have something more high-tech in mind. This is my bed. I am going to do a high-tech garden, a robot garden. It weeds, it waters, it plants. All you have to do is run the software.
You have to weed.
Oh, no, it's going to weed. It's going to weed for me.
No, it won't.
You watch. It's going to weed for me.
How does it know? AI?
Well, it's got a camera. It's got a camera, and it asks you, is this a weed? And if you say yes, it gets rid of it.
Sort of makes you up in the middle of the night. Is this a weed?
No, just
yeah,
watch
it. Blood out.
Luckily, I have a crack team of experts here.
Oh, yeah, we look like experts, all right. Here we go.
There we go. Now, can you push the dirt around, back around it? That a girl. That's it. Yep.
For years, I can remember gardening with my mom.
Good. And then we'll pat it in so it sits.
I don't have any gloves on.
You don't have any gloves on?
It's so great to be able to now have her be able to help me get this garden going. So that I can hopefully help create those same memories for our kids. Sorry.
You just make a little thin line because the seeds are very tiny.
Faster! Faster! Oh, wait.
The boys have been having some frustrations over here.
Your dad was the first one in the neighborhood to get a tractor. Innovators, me and Grandpa.
No, he's not an innovator. He uses the innovations and knows how to use it.
Okay.
The garden queen is right here, Charles. You are in her presence. All shall bow.
Doesn't this have to fit in here?
I want nothing to do with electricity and something that supposedly thinks for itself because it never does.
What do you think, Dad?
I'm not going to wait till you have it done.
I'm with you, Doc. Let's go eat.
I love you.
I would have said I love you back if we would have finished the robot. It's been a really great year on Pol Sheband.
We're cooking. Anyone?
Uncle Ben?
What inspired me to take on the project is that farming made me into who I am now. So I'm doing this for my kids.
All these buns are just falling down.
That's what makes me feel better about saving it. Small farms like these were a way of life in this country.
It comes from that side, and they made a living on it.
But it's becoming a lost art. So being able to keep that alive and preserve it is super important. A farm will teach you everything. It's going to teach you about life.
Guess what I see? A baby.
It's going to teach you about death.
So sad. I'm sorry, guys.
It's going to teach you about perseverance. Think I can, I think I can, I think I can.
Yeah, baby!
It's going to teach you about hard work.
Oh, man.
I'm not sure if that was poop or not.
Oh, it's so much fun.
Go, 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 go. Corn, pick the corn, pick the corn!
It's going to teach you about challenges.
No, no.
Going to teach you about supporting each other in the hard times. Matter of fact, a lot of things went wrong. But working together in teamwork is how we made it through it. A family farm is a powerful thing. And what you can accomplish is staggering.
Together we make a really great team. The farm has grown, and we have grown.
We have grown. Look at those pipes.
Oh. I mean, you can almost not put your fingers around them.
Farm fit, baby.
Farm fit. Hello, family. It is dinner time. Everybody, I'd like to propose a toast. Cheers to the farm.
Cheers to the farm. Salud.
My role in this entire project was to be the construction guy. But the deeper I get into this, the more I want to be here. Being with the animals, being with my sister, being with Charles, this farm becomes part of my heart and part of my family. I feel like I'm almost building something, not just for Charles, but something that creates a legacy for my kids, for his kids, and for hopefully their grandkids.
Are you proud of him?
I am very proud of him that he thinks that Charleston does it.
It took his knowledge, Ben's hard work, Beth's heart and focus, and I guess my big ideas to make it happen.
Yes.
We couldn't have done it without any one of us.
I think what surprised me the most was how much we've actually been able to do and accomplish.
It's that touch that you add to the farm that completes it. It really, you complete my farm.
Make me a little teary-eyed.
All right, everybody look. Mom, you gotta lean way in, Mom.
All right, here we go.
Good, let me eat. There.
When we say goodbye, you say, see you later, alligator?
No, after all, crocodile.
Thank you, everyone. Love you.